Hello, good evening. Today we are going to discuss a few things about the allied examination, and the most important or interesting thing would be the possible cutoff. So our team analyzed the question paper. Maybe you have seen our answers on website and Facebook. So what we arrived at is there were some 90 questions, which were pretty easy. So we could be scoring around 80 out of 90. Second is some mediocre questions. They were around 68. So one could be scoring in the tune of say 35 questions at least, and there were some 42 questions comparatively difficult, so one could be scoring around say 15 or something. So point is, it may total up to say 130 or something, but important factor is the number of seats. Number of seats, they are good, so possibilities there could be a cutoff of say 117 something marks. So let's see what happens. But irrespective of whatever we speculate, point is, if you are scoring anyway excess of 105 or something, there could be a chance. So point is, better buckle up and start preparing for mains, because it will take some effort and time to do it. So let's get into the mains thing. Mains this time and even last year also, it was conducted by a commission. So what they have done is they have made it pretty similar to HAS examination. And let's get into the thing. First is English, 150 marks. So it shall be having reading comprehension, some 10 marks or something. So point is, again, go to the questions, get back to the passage, read and trace out the answers. Second is pressure writing. You need to do 1/3 of the total content given in the paragraph or something. So that is pretty okay. Then essay is there, 30 marks in total. So essay is going to be critical. So point is, try to work upon your writing skills and vocabulary and even handwriting. That is crucial. There should be some questions for vocabulary or something. For vocabulary, you need to do maybe fundamental work like learning the Greek and Latin roots. If you do it, then in long run, that is going to pay you really well. And there is some grammar portion which is significant. It will be having articles, sentence correction, tense correction, and maybe verb or prepositions. So point is, you need to buckle up your grammar a bit. So try to fetch a book or something, try to take some help. Try to go online or something and try to improve it. Second is GS. Again, in GS, HP is always going to be significant. So HP, again, you can refer to maybe Dr. Athri's book. That is going to be good help in this thing. And try to focus a bit more on current affairs, because current affairs, they are going to help you in questions, and they are going to help in person, in news and places and names or something. So current affairs is going to be interesting. Similar thing happened in IAS examination, even HAS also. They have put in some good questions from current affairs. So that is important. HPBSC, they like data, they like decimal points or something. So better you buckle up your things with the sensors part and the data part of HP particularly. Then you come into the polity thing, and then interesting could be articles, the commissions, the freedom struggle thing, then the movements and the groups, then Gandhiji is important, so is the formation of Congress and various things which happened in the meantime. Then geography, again, need to put in some effort in geography and a bit about environment also. Then rivers, cities, banks, these kind of things, they are going to be important. Again, essay component is also there in this paper as well, so essay you cannot let go. So you prepare hard for essay thing, try to guess some questions, some topics which could be important, and there could be some generic topics, some contemporary, and then you try to research on those things, try to write some essay, and try to create a template, and there could be at least say 15 to 20 topics which you can think about, and then you can guess some of the topic which may be coming in the examination itself. So let's see. So after that, we get into the Hindi. Hindi, again, that could be the Achilles heel for Himachal candidates. So Hindi, need to be very careful. There should be some translation for 30 marks. There shall be Gadyansh ki vyakhya, Padyansh ki vyakhya, and stuff. So essay is there, Shuddhikaran correction is there, idioms and phrases, Muhavre Lokokti is there, and English to Hindi is there, one word substitution, and antonym thing is there. So point is, you need to be referring to some books at least for Hindi and English as well. Because GS, you could be okay, because you have, if you are potentially about to clear the pre, you should be good in GS. Point is, you need to go a little deep, that's it. But in English and Hindi, For example, in Hindi, you can take some grammar like Unicorn Grammar is good, and you can even take book of the Hindi Bhasha Adhyapak, TGT, PGD kind of books. These could help you, and you need to be reading newspaper if you don't do. And you should be writing your notes in Hindi. It will help improve your writing and quality of your writing. So Hindi, that could be okay. In addition to that, there is English thing. So English, you can refer to maybe Lucent or Oxford Grammar, which could be coming handy to you. For practice, you can think about the SSC Arihant book. That is also good, though there could be some errors, but still a good proposition. And apart from that, you can check Latin and Greek roots. They'll help build your vocabulary a bit. But again, point is handwriting and quality of writing. That is going to be very important in this examination. So take care. And if you need to contact us, you can contact us, and we can discuss a few more things. Thank you very much.